Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video I will cover most important topics for ISRO 2017 Fluid Mechanics Part 3. First is Euler's equation of motion. Its assumptions are important. Conservation of momentum, this is also important. Conservation of momentum, then assumptions, assumptions are important for IES also. Its assumptions are ideal fluid and inviscid fluid considering motion along a streamline and steady flow. Its equation is dP by rho plus gdz plus vdv equal to 0. Conservation of momentum is important and assumption is inviscid fluid. This is important. Twice asked in IES examination. And motion along a streamline. Sometimes they may ask this one also. Then Bernoulli's equation. Bernoulli's equation, its conservation of energy, its assumptions are ideal fluid and flow is incompressible, flow is steady and flow is irrotational. And if you integrate Euler's equation of motion, you will get Bernoulli's equation. Will get Bernoulli's equation here P by rho plus equal to constant. This is in terms of energy. And in terms of pressure head, it's P by rho g plus z plus b square by 2g equal to constant. Both are important in terms of pressure head. Sometimes they may ask numerical also, you have to use this formula or this formula. Then continuity equation, conservation of mass, rho 1 a1 b1 equal to rho 2 a2 b2, a2 b2. If rho is same, then a1 b1 equal to a2 b2. Three things are important, so many times asked in examination, ISRO, IES and other examination also. Euler's equation is conservation of momentum and Bernoulli's equation is conservation of energy. Continuity equation is conservation of mass. In applications of Bernoulli's equation, venturimeter is important. Venturimeter and Pitot tube, both are important. Orifice also important. Venturimeter measures rate of flow, V2, velocity at throat, it's A1 by A1 square minus A2 square into 2GH, theoretical discharge is A1 into A2 divided by A1 square minus A2 square whole root into 2GH whole root, Q actual equal to CD into Q theoretical. Here H is pressure head difference and its value is X into SM by S minus 1 when specific gravity of manometric fluid is greater than specific gravity of liquid which is flowing inside that pipe. This one we will use when Sm is greater than S, and this one we will use when Sm is greater than S, less than S, sorry. X is manometric deflection and Sm is specific gravity of manometric fluid. S is specific gravity of fluid flowing inside the pipe. So many times they ask this formula. So this is important. They will ask problems based on this formula. In orifice measures discharge. And one more thing is important here. If a tank, here one orifice attached, and time of emptying fluid through one orifice, its formula is this. Once they ask this formula, so you just remember this formula. Then Pitot tube measures a stagnant pressure, then from stagnant pressure we can calculate the velocity of flow. So this is very very important. 2gh, so many times they ask stagnant pressure equal to dynamic pressure plus static pressure. This formula you have to use. Then hydraulic coefficients, first CC, coefficient of contraction, area of jet at vena contracta, area of jet at vena, coefficient of contraction is area of jet at vena contracta by area of orifice, and coefficient of velocity is actual velocity by theoretical velocity, and coefficient of discharge is actual discharge divided by theoretical discharge, and its standard value. This is very very important. Cb is 0.612, 0.69, sorry, cc is 0.612, 0.69, and cb is 0.95 to 0.99, then CD value is approximately 0.62. And one more thing is important. CD equal to CB into CC. 3 to 4 times they asked. These three standard values and this one. Sometimes they are asking this one also. And one more formula is important here. Cb equal to xy 4yh. Discharge through orifice. This formula is very very important. And in viscous flow, Reynolds number is very very important. For laminar flow in pipes, Reynolds number should be less than equal to 2000. And for open channel flow, Reynolds number for laminar condition, it should be less than 500. And for transitional flow in pipe, Reynolds number, it's in between 2000 to 4000, and open channel flow Reynolds number should be greater than 500 and less than 2000. And for turbulent condition in pipe flow, Reynolds number should be greater than equal to 4000. And for open channel flow, Reynolds number should be greater than or equal to 1000. or pipe flow, this is very, very important. 2-3 times they asked in ISRO. For pipe flow, entrance length also they may ask. For Reynolds, laminar flow, hydrodynamic entrance length is LE by D equal to 0.07 into Reynolds number. And for Reynolds number, its formula is rho Vd by mu or kinematic viscosity term B into D by kinematic viscosity. D is characteristic dimension. It's 4 into voided area divided by voided perimeter. 4A by B. This is also important. Then shear stress distribution in pipe flow. Its formula is this one. Twice they asked in ISRO exemption and gate exemption also once they asked this one. Next, velocity maximum is 2 times of average velocity in pipe flow and average velocity is 1 by mu minus dp by dx r square by 8. And velocity distribution, it's parabolic. And shear stress distribution, it's linear. Huygens-Posley flow, this is for pipe flow. Huygens-Posley equation, this is for pipe flow. And Plane-Posley flow, it's when two plates are fixed, both plates are fixed and fluid is moving here, then it's Plane-Posley flow. Then Curtis flow, one plate is fixed, one plate is moving. Then it's Curtis flow. Thank you, friends. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you.